And good afternoon, everybody. Here for episode 31 of the Spare Change Challenge. Streaming it live here on Twitch. And I'm just starting to open NL tables up. Now looks like there's a bunch of nine-handed tables. Real quick, get us started here. Play a revolution 2 so we don't have empty slots. That looks good. This one filled up. Try this one for a bit. See. Won't be too long till we're in the big. Yes. I'm ready to go today. You tuned into episode 30. Might thought that I would hang from the ceiling today, perhaps. Yeah, it was a pretty brutal session. But we're going to do something a little different today. We're not going to pay attention to how we're doing. I'm not anyway. You guys can, obviously you can see the balances there. You can kind of follow along. Welcome to tell me if you think we're over 150 or not. But I'm not going to pay attention. We're going to play our session. And then at the end of the session, we'll see how we did. Go back to what we were doing before, because it's just not good. Look at your balance. No good can come from it. So, at least not from my end. I don't have complete... I'm pretty good with tilt control, but there might be some subconscious tilt going on. Like, I may not mean to be changing the way I play, but it may just be happening. So, I'm going to eliminate that. I'll play our game. What happens? And if you really think about it, the last session was pretty brutal, because we're so close to 150, right? But in reality, we were basically break even. So if you have a really terrible session and you break even, you shouldn't be upset, right? We should just be looking at it as just part of the journey. We're just going to go forward now. So with that being said, I have my Death Wish coffee here that I got my wife for Christmas. I'm going to be drinking that while we play, and hopefully that'll give us a little bit of a boost. I have to say it, I'm not really noticing, I've had a few cups of it, not noticing specific jolts or anything from it. Tastes pretty good though, I actually like it. Good. I'm sure that the Death Wish part of it is just a gimmick. I'd say it's a pretty damn brilliant one. Good idea for a brand, Death Wish Coffee. You know, everybody wants to do things in extremes, right? I mean, I guess I'm kind of a man of extremes myself when it comes to poker, right? I mean, how many people are playing a short stack, right? At least not as a long-term thing. I don't know. Seemed to be much literature on the subjects. I don't know if that's just from the fact that such a stigma against it, or whether damn hard, or I don't know. But we'll stick to our little niche here. And, prove that we can have a very high win rate without playing big stack or 100 big blind starting stack or whatever. I could just chase after that dead money, right? One of the great things about playing a short stack really is little hidden weapons you have. Well, not so hidden, maybe. But maybe people don't think about it. They're deciding, should I play 100 big blinds? The medium stack, by the way. Not a big stack. Comparatively speaking, it's a big stack, but it's actually a really awkward stack. If I was going to play more than 30, 40 big blinds, I would want to play 150 big blinds, right? because so much more room to operate, right? As we do get our first double up, that's good. So we're off to a strong start again this session. Could we just win that yesterday when we were at 148 or 149, right? But that's okay. It's a new day. Be about five. I think somebody put it five bones now away from Becca. But I'm not gonna try not to think about that. We're just gonna play our game. As we said, let the chips fall where they have a good session. I kind of like that red cash register. I win pots. Just something to do, right? I'm going to keep betting for value until somebody tells me otherwise here on the bottom left. And on a semi-blank river, that's not one of them. I was going to check call, but I think that's a check fold spot now. We're getting some notoriously bad runouts. They'll be good here. Goes to show you can bet for value with cards you would not expect to be able to bet for value. People will generally build a strength bluff there. People play pretty honest in a way. I'm assuming one of those two players was if they're even players, might not bluff there because they think one of us three players would have something we can call with, whether it be straights. Heads up pot, things change completely. So you can actually bet for value sometimes a little bit more thinly in your pots just because people are just going to reveal the strength. People aren't going to slow play as highway pot. Betting and their calling, they're going to have a lot wider range to do so. Well, not just because they're fish, but, well, that's not really what I'm saying. What I'm saying is don't get raised. You'll have not necessarily a hand. Maybe something you wouldn't even expect them to have, like overcards or bottom pair or an underpair to the board. Backdoor flush draws on flops. Whatever. There's a lot of video materials out there about backdoor draws. Too far. I think that's more of a deep stack heads up type situation play. I guess multi-way as well, but you got to be getting a damn good price to be facing backdoors without a plan anyway. Tough to have a plan when you're planning on taking a pot away in a multi-way pot, just because there's so many ranges connecting with a variety of boards and a variety of contingencies, turns, rivers. I think we have to bet for about this board. This guy's all in for 10 cents. About to fade 7. Not a tiny pot. Decent size little 30-40 pot. Take it. Find another Dodgers table. Promising, 39% tip. Guys stole our Derhi. Okay, stick with 3 for now. So let's assess our tables real quick. Not so good. I guess we'll be this one. This one. And we got this guy to our left. But these guys aren't exactly lags. I don't think this guy might be. Just too early to tell. We're gonna go and roll with this for a while just because 65 VP. The 31 VPIP table. What do you think? Right? Guys aren't full stacked. Got a guy that can sit here. We got 2 full stacks to our left. Hopefully nits. That would be nice. Let that one go. Eighty-six pip here. It would be raising an extremely wide range here with this player in the small blind. There we go. Eights is definitely in a very wide range. We will open it here. A really dynamic board. Heads up, I would bet for sure. That's probably pretty passive. I think I can just check back. We can try to get a showdown here. Yeah, once a passive 86-0 pots it on the turn, I think we build this table up here. There's a off of this one. Well, looks like there's some games running today, so that's good. Getting closer to end is a lot of people are off work for a portion of this week or the entire week. This chat's pretty funny up here in the top left. I don't know if you guys can see. Player number 5. I bet Russia hacked this site too. I won't even use a dating website. I could pick up so many chicks that way. But I know Russia controls it. Just another way to get AIDS. Getting double tapped by AIDS. Okay. Maybe that part's not so funny, but these are two random hands. I think we can get that ace cards. We slightly improve, but so do a lot of hands that would be calling our flop bet. I think there's a lot of rivers we can bet. If he checks back this turn, I think he's going to hate this queen a lot. Let's say he has pocket sevens here with a club. He's not going to fold, but he will fold a river bet once he checks back the turn, if that happens. Ouch. However, I was going to say, if the board pairs, probably a pretty bad card to bet. He could just have ace 10 here or something as well. What's he betting here? What would he check back the turn that he's suddenly betting now? Are there some hands that we're beating that might turn their hand bluff here? Clubs got there, but would he not bet the turn when I check? Pretty aggressive. 8-10 got there? Could he be turning 7s into a bluff and I get pwned here by calling? I think in a limp pot I'm just going to let this go. Because I have so little invested. But I think this is a bluff a lot. I'm trying to think of what he could have. 10. I'm pretty sure this is a bluff, but some of his bluffs are beating me. I don't think that's ever anything. It could be like a slow play deuces that suddenly has a boat on the river. Maybe. If he has a nut hand, that would make sense. But yes, like I said, limp pot, not much to fight for. If it was a heads up pot and it was a raised pot, that's a spot I could potentially check call with ace high. Sometimes. It's just because he bet so big. I think if he's thin value betting with like a jack there, he's just going to bet like 30, 40 cents. If he's bluffing, he's going to bet pot a lot. If he's got like a boat, whatever, nut hand, a flush, bet big too. Got it kind of a makeup bet because he checked back the polarizing bet. A lot got there. But let's say it hadn't run out clubs. And board pairs on that, right? Of calling there. I don't even think it's that close. I think it's a clear call. When it's close is when the club hit the turn. That makes it a little. But neither here nor there. He does leave the table, and he was the only soft spot, so I think he's going to probably stay out next big blind. A good hand to flatten the big blind if we get other callers. Not look like the case. Here we go. We'll call now. So, is it saying chat's disabled? This is a good spot to lead, I think. I think he's going to have... He has like a pair that's going to free him. And I think he might actually... Something like pocket. Kind of seems crazy that somebody would do that, but it's possible. I think we're gonna have to call one street. See what develops on the turn. We have backdoor club, so we're not really gonna. Club would actually be hard for us, I think. I think he's just got like a weak ace or a lot, and we want him to continue bluffing. I know it's a limped pot and all that stuff, but if he has queen eight, it's kind of hard for him to have a hand like. I think he's got to draw a lot. Ace. It is a limp pot, and I really don't like paying people off in limp pots. But clubs missed? Well, he just pounded away, didn't he? Like he's confident he has the best hand. What got there? 6-8 of clubs. We just have to pay this off. The limped pot, but could you just have like ace 10 and be doing this? Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Doesn't really make sense, but it makes sense. We're 3-bet with 9s with 17 big blinds, and this guy is playing like his first second hand. With this dead money in here, I think we just have to ship. Close. But can't just call. I think we could have way the best hand here when a guy min. Wow. Oh, who ran into king. That's not a good turn card, by the way. Okay, it's only 17 big blinds. He just sat down at the table. He min 3-bet. Kind of crazy to min 3-bet kings in that spot, but we're going to go in and get off this table as planned. This one, I don't know. Maybe we should have min raised the flop. But the only problem is I don't think with that board, with the draws out there, we can min raise fold. So if we min raise, he's probably going to ship in the same result. I don't think we want to really raise the turn because we want the draws to continue. We don't want to get him off his bluff on the turn. I think it's just a cooler, really. I mean, sure he's going to have queen 8 there sometimes, but I think he's also going to have like... Plain X, ace X, he's going to have gut shots that missed. He's going to have flush draws. Pocket eights is kind of weird in that spot. Because he didn't raise preflop. He just checked back with a pocket eights. Let's check on chat. Thing. Stable? Tables, let's see if we can get that slot filled. Like a new table, we'll try that one out. Two big stacks, but we'll wait and see who the next player is that sits. We'll take the seat accordingly. If it's a short stack, we'll sit to his left. Yeah, so we have a top pair and a gut shot. I don't think we're committed for sure on this board, but we definitely want to try and get some value from worse. I think it's an easy fold if we multi-way pot people. I think the gut shot's kind of irrelevant raised. So let me see if I can. What would be causing that? I don't know. That's kind of a tainted turn card, right? Gut shot. It's an okay barrel. We could definitely still have the best hand. Guess we have to fire that river. Although, off of 8x. I don't know. I think we have to bet again, though. Probably not going to fold a queen, but we could probably get him off like pocket 7. So yeah, I guess we have to fold our 2 pair now. I think there are no soft spots to our right here. So get the 4 lines off this table. I have no idea what's going on. So apparently, some kind of sound and chat being. I'm going to have to troubleshoot that. I'm going to maybe put out a couple hands. Test, test, test. We have to protect our hand here. There's better hands that can fold, for sure. Okay, so it looks like we've sorted out our issue. So I think this is a clear check back spot, and I think that's the kind of turn card we're looking for. We're going to min-raise a lead, protect our hand otherwise. We do get 3-bet by this player. Like, hasn't really that many hands. I'm just going to give him credit. Flipping here. Much. I think I'll let this go. I could sometimes open that. One look worth playing? I guess we'll give it a couple revolutions. Oh, yeah. Okay. Thanks for reminding me of that. I was showing the chat earlier. Bad about that. So I was probably talking about hands off screen earlier. If you're watching this on YouTube, I apologize for that. But I don't think we had any consequential hands. Nothing really earth-shattering, so I'm going to lead with the queen high on a drawy board with second nut flush draw here. We just take this down on the flop a lot. Good turn card. I think we could certainly still be here. I think we can get him to fold better hands for sure. I like a barrel off here. Depending on what comes on the river. Yeah, wait for mine, please. Crappy. Maybe it wasn't so bad. I think we could just check back here. Probably. Checking. Let's just see if we can get to the river here and have the best hand. A good board to bluff at, but he may not know that. And I was hoping he just had ace high, which he does. Down. Hope I have all the kinks worked out here. I tell you, I have a really bad short-term memory. I forget little things like making the table, isolating one table, all that good stuff. I'm a really bad multitasker. Like, I can focus on the poker, and I have a really good short-term, long-term memory for that. But I forget everything else, all the mundane stuff, like having my stream function properly. Wish I didn't have to have this delay so when we had conversations, I could talk. But alas, necessary evil. Get this suit. Oh, really? Clicked it. I swear I clicked it. Two seats and we can't even get one of them. Well, maybe this guy won't sit. Shucky ducky. Okay. We'll see about this pretty we can guess why. Oh, maybe we. I think it's just obvious. Guys, watching? Lots filled. Yeah, just this table. No. Sweet. All right, nice. All right, I feel good about poker today. Thinking good things are going to happen this session. In a heads-up pot, this might be a checkback, but I think in a three-way pot, it's a clear bet. Just aren't going to raise as light. It's a really good turn card for us. I mean, sure, somebody could have a straight right now. But I think we can also check back and just get the showdown versus a lot of hands that we're beating. Or it's going to be hard for somebody to turn a hand into a bluff on this board, is what I'm saying. And there's a lot of good river cards for us as well. I think if somebody has a 9, their bet, if they have 2 pair, they're just going to try and check it down. I don't think somebody's going to go for like thin value. So they bet with a 9 or they check. Either we're good, or they have 2 pair and we lose. You know? Not really concerned about this card is what I'm saying. I think we're still good like over half the time here. Unfortunately, we run into a guy we had dominated on the flop and he got there. But it's okay, it's a small pot. Profitable spot. And you can't win them all, right? And we're not really going to be able to get him off that. I mean, am I really going to bet that river? I would have to like over bet jam. Looks polarizing. I think I just have to barrel off with here. Turn our hand into a bluff here. I just think he's going to have ace highs. Well, not that we'd mind him calling with ace highs, but we're protecting and we can get him off like a 6 or pocket 7s that he lamped or something like that, you know. Same old theme as always. So that's the kind of spot you want to turn your hand into a bluff. I think this is a good spot against this type of player to do this. Last time I did this, I think we ran into like some big blind or something. But that's just highly unlikely. This is like a random hand, and we just want this guy to gamble, call, and then fold. We miss, or hopefully call if we're ahead on the flop, but it's like a hugely profitable spot there. And it targets this type of potential gambler type player who will call off the dollar. Because it's only a dollar, right? Yeah, just call, see a flop. Not a big deal. If I miss, I'll just fold. It's only a dollar I've lost. But it's like hugely, hugely profitable to have a huge range call there. Because you're just going to be folding like 70% of flop or whatever. I don't know what percentage. A large percentage. So when we miss, he might be folding the best hand. And when we connect, I've seen people call with just like queen high. No draws, no nothing. And we have king high, and we think we're crushed when he calls, and then suddenly, whoa, we're good. Table's not shaping up to be a great table, so we're probably just exito this table-o. A little bit of Spanglish lesson there for you guys. Pretty good at Spanglish. Interesting. I guess he could raise all his ace-x hands here. I mean, there's a certain amount of draws, too. Those draws have a lot of equity, probably. He looks like a tight player, I think. I mean, if I call here, I'm basically just drawing outs a lot. I don't know. Sometimes drawing dead. I just don't think this is a great spot. I think bet folding is just the way to go there. There's some player types that I would check that back and then returns, things like that. So a decent flop here. Have some equity. I think he's just going to have nothing here a lot too. So that's good. We go with 8 high. It's some flat some players here on the button, but this is the first hand he's raised. There was like a huge whale behind. I could flat that as well. I just don't think I can turn that into a profit again. Under the gun or hijack range there. Often against the tight player. I need to have more information is what I'm saying. I don't think in a vacuum it's profit. Let's get another table. This one. I think we were on this table earlier and it was good. Hopefully we can have this in. I don't know, a bunch of full stacks, we'll see. I think this is an okay spot to limp at, honestly. I want to keep these players in the pot. I don't really want to isolate with a hand when I have this potential behind me. This is an interesting flop. We obviously have 8 clean. We probably have the best hand a lot. But I think we need to protect that hand. Well, these guys have random hands, so... I could definitely get value from a 4 or a 3 or a 5 even. Ace high. That's a very interesting turn card. He could have 2x or 7x. We don't really want to just pile the money in here. We would much prefer to have the board pair and then get the money in. Or the board doesn't pair and we just call one bet, right? I think the hand just... This is the power of position right here. We decide how much money is going in the pot. So we'll check back. Now we can safely call or safely value bet if he checks. We'll just safely call. And wow... Okay, yeah. We knew he had that exact hand, we would play that differently, right? So we get a little... I wouldn't say we got lucky, because we did have 8 outs plus our 2 outs, so we had 10, 20, 30-something percent equity there, 38% equity on that flop. I'm just kind of glad he didn't raise that flop. Well, why would I say that? If I had known a 5 was coming, I would be glad that he was raising that flop, but we don't know that, right? If we knew he had a set and we had just an opener, we don't want to really get the money in, right? So I'm glad he slow played. But in hindsight, not glad at the same time, right? Wow. I don't think we can bet fold this. Depends on what people... here. Backdoor flush draw, two overs, and a gut shot. Strong hand. Yeah, I think we just have to pile with our straight and redraw to... We have two... and not that we're beat here, but I'm just saying we have the nuts, obviously. He only has 98 cents. Can we chance check in this back? We'd have to bet something. Let's bet like 30% of back. If he has a flush draw, this is going to be really gross. Really freaking gross. It looks like he's trying a block bet with like two pair or something. I'm just going to put the rest in. If he has a flush, good hand, sir. We just want to get the rest of the money with our nut hand. I don't think he's going to min bet a flush there. Actually, very pleased when he min bets. That's a good result. Find a couple fresh tables. Good tables, though. Games look pretty good today. Anybody got plans for New Year's? Special. I'm not. I do have some neighbors that we might go visit tonight. Last year we went across the street to the neighbor's house and we were there past midnight. Don't know if we'll do that this year. We may end up just staying home. Maybe go to bed at 9 o'clock. I did have fun last year, though. I don't think we had stayed up for midnight. I mean, some years I'll wake up just to watch the ball drop or whatever. But I don't know if I even stay up till midnight once in my 30s. Especially after I've been married and had kids. Because they're going to be up. You keep them up to 1 in the morning, they're still going to be up at 5:30 in the morning. And I just don't want to feel like shit for the work week coming up right after. I have to get up the next day, do paperwork, and then get out and my job on Tuesday. But if we stay up till midnight and just get to bed by 12:30, probably be okay if we lightly sleep in a little bit, maybe one day, Monday, or maybe take a nap. Maybe get some Death Wish coffee in us. I got an upset kid in the background. If you're hearing that, I apologize. And she went from crying to laughing. All in one breath. What are you doing? I could flat this, but this guy's wide on three betting, potentially. And it's not really the kind of hand I can backdoor trap with. There actually are some players I could do that with. King Jack. Very rare. This guy would need like 30% 3-bet over luck. I have been on this table. The only reason I'm staying on this table is because 42. Lots of games, just very little 10. This min 3-bet shit. I guess we have the right price. We're getting 26-1 implied odds, so I guess we have to call. So in case this guy is, like, accidentally min 3-bet there because he was opening and didn't realize we had raised, we got a lead. Because we do have the best hand against some of his betting range. We don't really want to check call. Although this bet maybe we should be betting more like 40. Because I think he can just raise a lot. Ace king. Like we might have a hand going to. I don't know. Interesting play. Has its merits, I guess. Especially if he times out here and folds. Maybe this guy just lost connection. That was lucky for us if he had like aces. Maybe that's a good argument for betting there. It's not my fault that he has a shitty internet connection. Right? Probably be back in a minute. Are any of you guys old enough to even know the dial-up connection sound? Rebecca, it was 1995? I think it was the first time I had lived on my own. By myself. Not the type of play you want a third and go. Or complete. And I was playing a mud called Highlands Mud. If I had to have my dial-up connection, I paid $10 a month for it. Very wary of this player limping. Very wary. 2010. He's going to have like a small pocket pair here a lot. I think I have to bet a little big on the turn. Because I think he could still call with like 8s or 9s or 10s here. But I don't want him to like raise with those hands. So I could be pretty confident in my fold if he raises now. I'm pretty sure he had some kind of small pocket pair. But I don't want him to turn his hand into a bluff. I bet there. This table sucks, doesn't it? Where's my soft spots at? There is not a... Although I do have tight players to my left, which certainly is bad, but that's not really the type of poker. That's just a bonus for me to abuse while I'm waiting to get off the table, because I want to make the big win rates, and the only way to get the big win rates is to play against really bad players. I might just... On this table, I might maybe beat Drake or have like a 2 or 3 or 4 big blind win rate. But I'm looking for that 10, 15 big blind win rate. And to do that, you have to keep bad players on your table. Yeah, the dial-up sound. Anyways, I was playing this Highland mud. I mean, that's all I did was I worked my job. I was thinking I was taking a break from college at that point. And I worked my job. And I went home and played this Highlands mud. And I wasn't with my girlfriend, I guess. I could ISO pretty wide. He looks pretty loose. I think the sixes is a value shove. I'm going to limp to this because the player's 17-0, and we'll see him sideway pot, yada yada. Not getting a very good price. Unless the whole table calls. We made a side to call. Bet here and we'll fold. Not a very good table, I don't think. We'll be getting off of this one now. I think our soft spot left. Hey, good old AOL. I never had AOL. Kind of miss that, though. Those early days of the internet, you know? So, what's the word? There was just this magic to it, you know? Like you were doing something nobody had ever done before, which I guess we kind of were. I don't know, it's just... I would much prefer to be the generation that didn't grow up with it as kids, because it's just... I guess we can appreciate it more. And also remember the times before, and actually have kind of a sentimental feeling, because kids nowadays are all attached to the... basically attached to their ear and their lap. They can't get through a freaking movie without turning their phone on, you know? The movie theater. Yeah, I miss all those old stuff. I actually want to get back into... get me a record player and get some of the old tunes. Just the scratchiness, the sound of the... all the retro stuff. I think that's coming back. It's definitely niche markets out there for it. Get an extremely good flop for our... Pocket Queens, we have like an SPR of 1.23, whatever, because this player is short. So I think we can do a little bit of an inducement bet and bet 30 cents less than we bet. We're committed here, so it doesn't really matter what peels off on the turn. We're just hoping he ships here. Get what we want, and we win. Well, we have a lot of equity, not we win, because, I mean, we could still run out as a loser there. We had 70% equity or something. I wasn't trying to get ahead of myself, but... to me, a win is when you get your money in ahead. Whether the money, whether you actually win the pot is irrelevant, right? Because if that happens a million times, we're going to win a shit ton of money. That's what I meant. I wasn't trying to be cocky or whatever the word is. Like, you shouldn't be getting excited when you win a pot. You should be getting excited when you get it in with the best equity. You should be like, yeah, I got it in with the best equity. And then just don't even worry about what happens after that. That's the attitude you need to have to succeed. Poker. That's what I'm trying to get back to. I used to have that eye of the tiger or whatever, but I guess variance got me for a little while, and I kind of got away from that. Started focusing too much on results. I definitely don't want to do that. Try and revamp our tables. Vamp. Reload. We get some more tables up. I don't know what the... let's look at this nine-handed table and see what the dynamic looks like here. Seat. Be in the blinds quick. This seat. Yeah, did this guy limp under the gun? Limped under the gun. Take that seat. By the way, it's not auto-sitting because... feature is broken. It was broken in Bovada and it's still broken in Ignition. Select your seating, your preferred seating for nine-handed. At least it doesn't work for me. It just goes away next time you turn off your clients. That's why I keep having to read. Not that I don't know about the whatever, or not that I'm lazy. It's I keep doing it and boom, it stops working. I think we can still bet for value on this turn card. Pretty small. And we get a pretty lousy river card, honestly, because I think there's a lot of Jack X hands. There's certainly some backdoor flush draws that could be possible as well. I think if we're good here, he's going to check back, and I think if we're beat, he's going to bet. I don't think there's that many bluffs here, bets. So I think just checking and folding is probably the best. Now, this just looks like thin value, like a Jack. If I knew this was like a super high-level regular or something, I'd damn this. But I think with showdown value, I'll just call. Just to show you, this guy has like Jack 10, Jack 8, Ace Jack. I mean, I would be surprised to see the nuts, but I think most likely that's just like the hand he got. Queen 8. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. That's showdown value. But yeah, if I was playing high-level... against a high-level player there, and this was like 600 NL, I would just ship that river a lot. Pick ship. Because I think I would play that way with a back... if I backdoored a flush, if I backdoored or got shot or, you know, something like that. I think that's the way I would want to play it, because he's going to have a lot of busted draws himself. Maybe something he slow played. I think he's going to have a lot of bluffs. I think he's going to fold everything that we could get value from, and I think he's going to bet his bluffs and bet his stronger hands. So I think a check shove is probably superior with my entire strong range and my entire weak range, like the hand I actually had, which is technically just not even a good bluff catcher there. I don't know. I should have probably just did it just to show. Because I think he just snap folds queen 8 there if I do that. Yeah, chip in their head. That's for sure. Oh, that reminds me. Have you seen the series Black Mirror? Got some pretty interesting... It's a pretty dark show. Haven't seen it. I would highly recommend it. Kind of a futuristic take on where technology is potentially headed, I think, for the most part. And how people are becoming so reliant on technology and kind of the negatives and sometimes, I guess, positives of that. Yeah, it's a pretty good show. Me and my wife watched it. I don't know if it's still ongoing or if they're going to do any more. Watched everything that's out there now on Netflix. I think it's a Netflix show. I don't know. We got rid of DirecTV this year. Have Netflix, Sling, and I guess do Amazon Prime on demand, probably for Game of Thrones. Yeah, I think our bill's like less than $50 a month now for TV. Maybe even 40-ish. I just got sick of DirecTV and cable charging you like $40 just to rent their shit, you know, box or whatever. So that's $100 a month we're saving. I definitely, that $1,200 a year we can put toward better use renting some box. And I like the streaming thing. I feel like I have more freedom in TV. A lot of the stuff we watch doesn't have commercials. Of course, we used to basically DVR everything on DirecTV. We didn't watch commercials anyway, but that's neither here nor there. I miss the old days of gaming. I think I may have mentioned this before. We have a original Nintendo that I bought my wife last year for Christmas. I bought her a cartridge that has 140 games on it this year. We've been playing that a lot. Probably going to do that after I get off of here. Minraise? Play this multi-way pot with 83. I don't think we need to bloat the pot. We're probably in position, not anymore. But I don't mind playing multi-way with. Yeah, I wish I had just discovered poker back in 2001 or 2. Internet poker. Didn't discover it till 2007 or 8. Watching my dad play on poker. Because I was really into games heavy in the early 2000s. I would have definitely gotten into poker heavy. And hopefully, or likely, pretty serious about it and done pretty well. Back when the game works pretty good and soft. So what do we think about ranges here? Has this guy just got to have something like 7s or 8s value from that? Do I have to just commit? That small, deuce. Am I really going to induce anything from this player? This player has some ace highs. I think it's going to be very tough for him to call with like pocket fives or pocket six sevens. He's not the type of player maybe to turn his hand. I just don't know. The thin value spot? I hate this freaking ace. If he was a reg, I could bet this card because it looks like a card I should be betting. I'm just going to check back. He didn't have a handy call with any. But a reg, I would thin value bet there. I would probably bet call because I don't think he's going to check shove. Can I get live sports? Sorry, I missed your text or your message. Yeah, I do. I've got NFL Sunday ticket. I think we're getting a free trial of that. And we pay the $5 a month for CBS, some one of the networks. Maybe a couple of the networks, I don't remember. Maybe we have that network package, I don't remember. But yeah, I only watch the Gators when they play college football and the Bucks play. Kind of disappointed in my Bucks. I mean, I'm not disappointed in them, I'm just disappointed that they couldn't pull it off late in the last couple games where they had opportunities. So now they just have to hope for a miracle to make the playoffs. They have Carolina on Sunday, which they have a really good chance of winning. They're at home. And they're better than Carolina. But I think several teams have to lose or win for them to make it now. It's like a 0.2% chance. We get a little flippage here. We do it? Not. Reload. Don't mind losing flips. Not a big deal. Find another table here. Something tells me that hand would have gotten us to $150. Just a guess. Guarantee is there. I have a slight inkling of a feeling, but you know what? I'm not going to worry about that. I said I wasn't going to worry about that. I'm going to take this. Actually, take this seat. Actually, I don't know what seat I'm going to take. This guy's a shorter stack. Ah, shit. I guess I'm stuck with this. Take this one. Flat here versus a cut-up open. This guy's appears pretty tight, but I think I can profitably play ace-jack in position. I'm going to lead with two. Good shot. Here. I like this flop because I think we're good here a lot, and I think we can definitely get him to fold some beat by. Does bet sense. Yeah, I think flatting here is standard. I think he's just going to check fold a lot on turns. We just check back. We have the best hand here sometimes. Is he going to fold? I don't know. I think I'll check back here. I think we're good here sometimes. Small value bet. I don't know about this one. Are we just committed with 16 big blinds behind with two overs and a gut shot? Could we get in versus queen 10 and 8, 10? How many clean outs do we have here? Worst case scenario. Can I just peel? Are we getting a good enough price to peel? Yeah, we're getting 6-1. We can peel. And, I mean, our actual hand is irrelevant. I think we had the right price, direct odds to draw to our gut shot or two overs. And there is some realm of possibility that we, a king or queen, could be good. But I think we could just save $1.26 now with this run out. Rather than shipping, because the only time we would want to ship that on the turn or flop would be when we knew we had fold equity, and I guarantee we had no fold equity. So we either just had to have, we had to have the correct direct equity, which we did not. It's like the two ranges we're up against, because some of our outs are dirty as well. You have to keep that in mind. All the diamonds are probably dirty. I'm guessing this guy probably has to have the flush, if anybody. It's kind of a gross spot for this guy, but I think if he had a strong hand like Jack 9, he should be bet folding that, not checking and folding. It's kind of a difficult spot because he had a one pot size bet left. I don't know. Because if you bet small, could you be inducing? I guess if you bet like $1.50, he'd have to call it off because he might have induced if he had a super strong hand. It's kind of weird. And I think this guy would just call with all of his back X hand. That's why you don't want to play 100 big blinds, right? Exactly that spot. We would have been all in on the turn there. Yuck. All those tables available, and I picked the one I've already been on. I'm going to ship the nines. Like a decent nine-handed seat here, so I think. For this revolution, anyway. This looks like a decent seat. A low VPIP table of only 30. Beggars can't be choosers right now. It's 50-50. Ball. FX. Button. Pretty passive so far, but this is only four hands. What am I talking about? Thing. But he has raised 3 out of 5 hands. 2 of those were in steal positions, though, so that doesn't really mean anything. I'm just going to fold to a pot size bet, I guess. And ship lines on the bottom left. Maybe that wasn't such a good call pre-flop, I don't know. I think I would prefer to have loose players behind me to not aggressive loose, like passive loose. I don't know. I mean, if he was a legitimate 1.0 aggression factor, I think calling is fine because he's just going to check fold. He's probably fit or fold, so. Yeah, I got a little ahead of myself there, I think. Ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Top of a ring again. Hearts. Thing about nine-handed tables is you do run into a lot of big hands. Pre-flop. But this guy's 45-27 effective hijack, and nines are like super plus EV. Not so. Worry about it. Sometimes you run into big hands. Like I made a minus EV play or nothing. Something. Probably ship a pretty wide range in this spot in the dynamic, but 5-3. If I knew that was going to be the flop, I would have. I forgot about my coffee. A little bit Luke cold now. That's a word. Yep, so we're going to bet this. The hate it or love it type board. Bet our 10 high. Bet a little bit bigger than half pot just because we don't play with like the line up diamonds or whatever. Whatever was possible. Mid diamond. Don't really want to buy that. This table looks pretty bad. Bunch of aggros pounding on our blinds. And any fish. Abandoned ship on this. It was promising up front, but didn't turn out to be that great. I like having these spades here. A lot of possibilities. I guess we have to fold to that. Hence the snapshot. Two overs and gut shot. Want to realize equity here, or do we bet? Probably just c-bet. You should always have a vacuum 3-bet range from all positions versus all position raises. And the blinds, nines, from any position. Unless I have a read. I'm talking about vacuum. Words. Against typical opening ranges, typical calling ranges. I think I have all my vacuum ranges. Rested? I'm gonna open ship the eights on 10. Play raise fold. A four-handed pot. Go after this 15 cents here, which is like 15 stack. Certainly get called by worse as well. We call by queen 9. And we hold. I think this is a pretty good table to stay on, especially with this guy calling shoves with cutoff. Type of player you want to play against. Time for a double up, right? I mean, a full double up. It's been a while. Hey guys, this is Jim with AutomaticPoker.com.
Sorry. Buddy messaged me on YouTube. All about, and I accidentally my up. Yeah, I'm not gonna barrel off versus a 90-70 here. I'm just gonna check fold this turn. Glad he showed the hand. I do wish I had this seat right here. He is 90-60, so I think I can limp in the button if it folds to me here. But I have 20 big blinds. I'll probably be shipping it pre-flop. Yeah, I'm going to limp. Hope this guy raises, right? 90-60. Eh, you sucker. That's not what I wanted. Guess I should just shoved over the lamp. Leads for 20 cents. I think we have the best hand here quite often. I don't think we can just call, though. I think we're just going to raise fold. Try to get it show. Yeah, that's a good river. I don't think he has a king here very often. Yep, that makes perfect sense. Didn't really want to just call three barrels, and I could see this type of player doing that. I don't really like having a 90-50. Maybe I should be tightening up quite a bit. Standard C bet on 8 high. Shut down if called. Okay, hold that. There's a lot of limp shovey spots we can have here. I don't think we're going to slow play the... We would be expected to slow play this, so that. I think he's bluffing, like, always here. So I think we just have to call this. Probably just get the money in on turns. We can't slow play again. We can't have a jack or an ace peel off on the river. We don't want to shut down. We don't want to kill the action. I think if he has 10 jack, he's going to pay us off anyway. If it was a deuce, we could slow play again. Yeah, we don't want to, first of all, give him a cheap card, and we also don't want to have scare cards for him come on the river. Kill our action. I think he basically probably had 10x there, as always. We'll limp here, we'll fold there. Flop here. We have a gut shot in the back door. Flush draw, so we'll do that. Fold. Happily take this one down.
Reason to open the Jack Nines. Has lost a lot of money. Even though he doesn't particularly look. Tighten up on the button here with the guy. Off this table. I gotta call out a position. A good table. Minus EV table. Not even a slight winning table, perhaps. Alright, this one. It's a high VPIP table of Irish Derby. 48 VPIP. Eh, I guess this is okay. That's playing like every pot. He actually folded this one. I guess have to see bet the king high. I don't know. Eh, I guess we can fold. No! Get the straight. So we would have a limp, a pretty wide limp shoving range. Although he does look like he's normalizing to a slightly less maniac-y type, is that a word? Maniacish HUD. I think it's still way to go with this guy. So like maybe any pair, any ace, king jack, king queen. If you're watching the stream, I guess you know my strategy now, so you can crap the shit out of me. Assuming people playing these games will not be watching me stream. You never know. In that case, I need like a 2-hour delay probably, right? That would be impossible to watch because there would be no interaction. I might as well just record a YouTube video, right? Get a fourth game up here. On that tip. Okay, how to play. How to play. He looked like the type that would bet if I check. Don't want him to fold. Don't want to see a turn card because he could improve. Okay, we'll take this. Just run out of chop. I don't know why these guys run so good against me. I mean, I guess it's better than losing, right? But I don't know why people with very high VPIPs that are aggressive don't run so damn good against me. Of course, if he had been running good there, he would have won, right? So we'll take a chop. We'll keep our $2 stack. Can't seem to find the code to beat these guys. Those type of players are the reason I had such a big low... I ran so far under V for so long. I kept getting in really good spots versus those type of players and finding a way. I think I was on this nine-handed. Sit here preliminarily. Something else opens up, we'll jettison. Oh, we're gonna take that one. Can't get on it quick enough. Good six table right now. If it would just open. Okay, I clicked the button like 20 seconds ago. Can I get the seat? Ugh. Man, I hate this laggy site. Maniacal. Yes. Thank you. I'll try to add that one to my dictionary, my mental dictionary, my... I can't even think of the word for what you call that. My vocabulary. There we go. I am, like, the worst words when I'm put on the spot anyway. When I'm writing, it's one thing. When I'm talking, of course, I have thesaurus.com at the ready. Always. I was looking at a couple tournaments tomorrow, and I accidentally registered. Just unregistered. Glad I caught that. Notice the registration was still up on my screen. Like a dollar or something, but back in my bankroll, so this is a good spot. Oh shit. I don't know why it's deleting your messages. Weird. Oh, we lost a flip. No. I'm actually ship the 10 deuce for 30 cents. And like a huge plus if you spot if this guy could somehow find a fold button. I know this guy should be finding a fold button. He has a random hand. Oh, yes! We're gonna chop probably here. Okay, free roll. take that! Why can't that happen to us on a $6 pot? Why's it gotta happen? Why do we have to run good on the 80 cent pot, right? Oh, this is probably a fish here. I guess maybe he just thought he had the right price. He's not necessarily a fish. Similar spot as earlier we played. Just bet for value on the turn, except this time we have top pair. Even better. This does complete some two pairs. We'll pick up some equity, so we could see a raise here potentially. So definitely bet fold this, I think. I think it would be strong to get raised on this card. You know, 8-7. Somehow people could have king. Seven. Here we go with jacks again. Put it all in. Ace queen's going in. Lines. So yeah, I think this might. Bet full. Check call. Check 10 is the only thing really got there. Could be a check call. Ah, chop. Well, I guess that's a good card for maybe chop, because I think he was ahead, right? I'm so hoping he called by something worse than me. We would have expected to bet the ace, so I'm just going to check now. I know I could be giving a free card to a lot of cards. I think it's just bet fold now. Well, is it a bet fold? Could he bluff? Could bluff worse, right? I want to flip. So many outs. Oh. Oh, are we 0 for 3 in flips this session? He could definitely have a 4 in his range. He could definitely have some busted draws as well. Popping with a 6 and worse. I don't know, what do you think? Is this a bet fold? He's min raising. Wouldn't he bet bigger if he was bluffing? Just have to call because we have the good price now. I guess we just have to pay him off. Yeah. He bet exactly the amount I could call. If I think if you make raise to 60 there, I have to fold. So, it's just unfortunate he had that hand. I can't fold the ace jack here. I'm too short. Probably beat, but I'm getting the right price. And three way, that's even better. Can I bet here? I can bet with two overs, even. 5-way pot. I guess we're going to have to reload. We were flipping for a triple up. Oh, man. Damn lag. Not the best card to bet on the turn. But that's a really good river card. I think we can do this. Fours again, man. Fours. Trip fours. That's our nemesis this session. Well. Oh, we're getting owned by 4x this session. What are the odds he's going to be the one guy to call the flop and have bottom pair or whatever that was? Yeah. Oh, we're running bad this session. What else is new, right? We got up to a good start, though. And it's not over. We have 30 minutes. This could turn back around. This table's so good, I think we can post in the cutoff. Look at this, fish, 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 fish. Yeah, we're definitely posting in the cutoff. And a poster here, too. We're not going to raise the 8. Played under the cuff. We're going to insta-check back here. I don't think we need to protect, and we don't really want to get it in. Better aces will get it in. I think if we can keep it to two streets here. I know we only have 18 big blinds, right? So technically we are committed, but I think keeping it to two streets is superior. And now there's a lot of hands we could buy you from, right? We can't have an ace. We checked, right? I'm not gonna bluff in it. Calling state. Gonna take my showdown, hopefully to showdown. Hey, we're good sometimes. Do we just get it in? We're committed. We want to keep this guy in the pot. Let's call. If a diamond peels, so be it. We should not be able to ever have a boat here. Maybe we could get like a hero call. Do we bet our whole stack or just like $1.20? I think he's just bluffing a lot, so I think he's either gonna have a hand he can call with or he. I don't think there's any point in betting small here to get like a hero call from. I think either he's going to have a six or a king and hero call, no matter what we bet. Hey, Pecoman. Yeah, if you're talking about the heads up sit and goes, I really enjoy those as well. Looking forward to playing those again. I'm just not going to play it under rolled, and I'm not going to play the dollar ones because I think our hourly should be higher here. Maybe we could play one at the end for fun. Got shot. I bet. We were given the opportunity. It's too random hand, probably. 50-13. We need something to go good this session, you know? Not very much has gone good. Not since the first couple hands. Bet this. Been kind of like losing every all in, you know? Kind of old. Every all in. Kind of wears on you after a while. Yeah, I think we can, we just protect our hand with the tie. We're probably good most of the time. And we can get hands with a lot of equity to fold, like jack high, not queen high. We're going to lead with the flush draw. I think we just take it down there a lot. Maybe even get somebody to fold deuce. We'll ISO the 10. Even though we're probably going to see a four-way pot quite often with this dynamic. Three bets a lot. Give eight. Wow. We turn a ton of equity. Check shove now? I think we just check shove. That king 10 suited, I would be damn tempted just to get it in here. This guy's losing a lot. I'm never just going to check call. Really, this guy's losing a lot. Aggro. Get some value with it. Oh, this guy called. Okay, I guess we can... Well... I guess we'll fold. Kind of a weird spot. I know this guy's full of shit a lot. We're going to defend against the player. This wide range. We have two overs and a gut shot. However, we have to keep in mind that ace high is probably not going anywhere forward, but I think we have to bet. On a safe turn. A three would be a really good card, right? I guess up here. We're not going to turn our hand off with counterfeit there. We'll just get off of this table. Anything else? Just because ace high, king high is calling us. Time. So we have 10s. Good spot. Definitely a value shove here versus a cutoff range. Okay, so this guy is really tight. He can limp these 10s. I don't know. It's kind of strange when you see a guy limp 15-8. I think when the money goes in, he's just going to like a set. But we have to consider probably we have the nuts here. I mean, it is a limped pot. I think people are going to reveal if they have a 3 here. I mean, it's possible. Are we really going to get raised by a 10? That's the danger, right? Somebody to raise with a 10. I guess we could check back, but we really don't want to give a free card to all the jacks, queens. Please, can we fold this? We just call one street. I think we kind of have to, right? Because in case he has a flush draw, he'll now give up because it looks like we have a three. I don't know. I don't know. This is kind of a weird spot. I probably should have checked back the flop. I think I made a mistake on the flop. It's probably the danger of getting somebody free card better than getting bluffed off a worse 10. Oh, this guy is so loose. And please. Well, want to get involved in pots, even though I know we're in the worst position possible. We want to play pots with this guy, so get any piece of this board we can check of. Okay. Maybe that's not a good call, actually. I don't know. If I knew this guy was a fish, good call. He did call, so it made it okay. Yeah. I gotta be a little careful of that. I think button would have been better. I don't know. Queen 10 suited though plays really well. Supposedly. What this guy got 9-8. Pocket fours. Really not pocket fours, right? Really bad play if he had pocket fours. He needs to call this guy bluff again. And limp. This guy might be on tilt though. But I think he might be on tilt in 3-bet too. I do want to see flops with these players. It's a really good table. Capitalize. What do we do to get down a buy-in here? lose a flip earlier. Probably have the best hand now. Bet for value. Yeah, we've been on this table a while. Really weird to be on a table this good for this long. I think we'd be able to just pile the money into our bankroll, right? So this guy's got a huge variety of holdings to call this turn. Like, he could be kind of play machine-ish too. Check back this river if given the opportunity. This guy bets, we just fold. See that being a strong hand. Passive. Another award-winning run out for us. I feel like a punching bag today. You guys are seeing the variance kick in firsthand for the last 3-4 sessions. We've kind of been running bad since we got to around the $130 range, right? Kind of backed up a while. Got back up. Now we've gotten tantalizingly close twice. Can't seem to get over the hump. A good spot to limp. Player. Stealing 89%. Really? Really? What do you have? 7 deuce offsuit? That's a really bad beat for this guy not to raise. This guy's kind of passive, but we still have to put it in. I mean, our plan was a limp shove. He could definitely be doing this with, like, sevens. Or aces, too. He could just have aces. So it really didn't matter what happened here. Yeah. Brutal. So this guy, if he had ISO, we would have got it in anyway. Well, maybe we could fold if he 3-bets. I don't know. Yeah. I blame this player. It's all his fault. So that's the third time we ran into overpairs, I think. Session. What are you going to do? We ran into a set one time, too. Had top pair. A brutal session. This is the session I didn't want today, but you got to do what you got to do, right? You got to just take whatever comes to you. We might be down to like 120 after today if we're lucky. I think we were close. We were winning a dollar earlier, weren't we? Were we not? Then we lost that all in. Flip. We could have just quit. Hit 150 if we had won that and be playing 25 NL. But you know what? Maybe we're running this bad in 25 NL and we drop like 50 bucks too. So maybe it's a blessing in disguise that we didn't get there. Let's get all our variants out of the way here at 10 NL, right? Not gonna let it ruin my day. We have, what, about 20 minutes left? Grinding away. Semi-good flop here. Don't you do it. I'm going to raise if you do it. Right, so he paused. A lot of time he likes his hand when he pauses. But he could just be on the toilet too. Who knows? Bet this board. That one. Did we barrel off against the 74-0? I mean, we do have like nothing here. I don't know. Bet that. We just have to bet again just because we have 10 high. I mean, he's probably not going to fold, but we got to bet again because we have 10 high. Maybe he folds something. You know? Obviously, he's not folding that. But we do have to bet there. I mean, he could just have, like, busted gut shots and stuff that are beating us. So we turn a straight. Hard to get value. But we don't really, do we really want to give a free card? We don't want to get free rolled either, because if he has like Jack X with a club, I think we just got to play a river. Raise this. All this. Wow, got some value from Ace Queen. Nice pot. I do run like ass. That's a good way to put it. Yeah. Better. Check back this week. Here. Invariably get the ace on the turn, which means we can't get any more value and we could be beat. Thanks a lot. Screw you, Barry Greenstein. Oh wait, that's ace on the river. Ace on the turn is my nemesis. But I mean, Jack X can call us here. We would be expected to bet an ace on the turn, so we definitely can get value here from worse. And there's club draws, there's other bullshit. Guy gonna lead the river? Looks like he's gonna lead the river. Oh, when he leads. Raise? Came off a weak ace? Turner hand into a bluff? Eh, we'll just go to... Yeah, he just had a club draw. He thought about bluffing. Means our raise wouldn't have been necessary, but it would have been good, I think. Because that way. Although they're leading sometimes on the turn. We need to get the mojo back here. I think what it just takes is just hitting some frickin' hands. I mean, getting it in with an overpair. I mean, hitting a set. Hitting a straight when somebody else has two pair. I mean, we just haven't had that scenario come. It's just been a grind. And we're losing flips now, too, all the time. So this is how it kind of piles up on you, Variance does. So gotta get through it. We're going to get through it. I mean, we'll have this explosion of money just piling into our account here. It's going to happen. You keep making good decisions. Assuming we are making good decisions, hopefully. It's actually a good spot to shove, believe it or not. This guy is actually 26-4. Oh, it may seem like we're throwing away a buy-in here, a dollar or 12 big blinds, but I think we get call, and we're like, we're going to have more than enough equity in a 3 or 4 all-in here with... This may seem crazy, but I think this is hugely plus EV. This guy has a lot of big cards in his range for sure, like ace-king. This is like hugely plus EV if we get like 4-way all in here. Hugely plus EV, trust me on that. Alright, not the best flop, but not the worst either. I mean, there's potential here. So we're betting a dollar to win $4. I don't know, could we be good here? Could be good here. Maybe not. Oh, queens. Queens, no. Okay. So I could run the equities there just to show you. Maybe I'll do that in just a second. Save this hand. Let me try and get another table up first. I want to run the equities just to show you why that was plus EV. Even if we knew this guy had queens, I think it's plus EV. It's 328. Might set heads up at some point. Okay, there's no tables right now, so let's pull this hand up. Let's do the equity on it. So we do know their exact holdings. 9-6 call there. Nice. Put this here. We had Jack 10 of clubs. We were against queen of clubs, spades. Was some dead money involved as well from, right? Had 9 hearts, 6. All right, so free flop had 18% equity. Is that right? That's it? That sucks. All right, so we have to forget that this guy had exact queen. Think about it. If we're basically in a 4-way, we're getting 4-to-1 on our money, right? So how often do we need to win in that spot? Not 25% because we were in the blinds, Probably something like, we need like 22% equity against their ranges to make that profitable in that spot. And we had 18 against the exact holdings, but just take this guy's range here. Change it. I mean, change it from an exact hand to a range. Put these. Well. So now we have 30% equity, and it's like hugely snap of plus EV. This guy was a fit, so. Yeah, even if you just put in that range there, we're still over 25% equity. Anyway, that's why that's plus EV. It's the range we're against, not. We knew he had queens, I guess that's a fold. Unless we knew these two were going to call. So, anyway. I was in the blinds, that helps things a lot. I think it was on this table. Definitely shipping. Plus two buy-ins on this table. So, yeah. Hopefully not a third here. Off that one. See what happens here. We might sit. Table. Yeah, we're gonna see the table. Right. Ooh, Jack's first hand. Take it. What do we do? Just shove? Make it look like we're sitting down in our maniacs? A maniac? Come on, you've waited all this time to play, and you get shoved on. You have to call there. Bro. Darn. May look like we're losing value there, but I think that's a good play. You have to get called infinitesimally smaller amounts there to get to make that profitable, rather than raising, playing out of the worst possible. Table. Probably. Can limp the ace four suited here. So we have about 10 more minutes, so I guess probably not loading any more tables. We're going to play these out for 10 minutes and see what happens. Try to get some more money back. So if you take the last three sessions we played, it's hard to imagine running better. Running worse than those three sessions in a row. Each individual session was just so terribly bad, and hopefully we're not down too much, right? Lead this 10-7. We can credibly rep something, and I think this guy just gonna fold like a lot. So let's win it with 10 high and move on. It's actually a good barrel off spot right there. Just hard for somebody to call three barrels when likely I have repping. Lead this gut shot, right? Why not, right? Nine, please. Ten, that works too. Get a little bit small to get some value from, like, guys maybe frustrated. I think. Deck full. God, that sucks. But what nines could he have in his. I guess. Is he gonna bluff? Like, what does he have that he can bluff with here? You're really going to, like, bluff fives now that he called two streets? Just have to have, like, a 7 or a 9x. What bluffs are in his range? What would he call the flop with? Call the turn. Chip now. Go down value. I mean, 76-0, so I think I have to give him credit here. I think he checks back anything that's value-ish. Yeah, I mean, he actually rivered me there. What the hell, man? Call a queen 9 on a 7-7 jack and somehow get there? That's running good on his part. A little bit, I mean, he did have us dominated, but hell, we hit the 10 on the turn. 8 on the turn? Pretty gross. Yeah, you can't limp fold. What did I shove there? I think that was... Well, actually, I don't mind the shove. Well, yeah, I do. I don't know. On one hand, you have people that could potentially light call there. But on the other hand, I don't mind seeing like a 3 or 4-way pot with queen. I think if I ISO there, I'm going to see at least a 2-way pot. Probably. I don't know. I mean, it's probably just an ISO, not a shove. Well, I think I got a little trigger happy there with the way I'm running. But I think it's plus EV either way, and it's probably pretty close either way. So this 26-5, 3 bets is so 5-7s. Don't set. No set. I'm paranoid about that. Then you know you're running extremely bad when it's like Jack 7-7 and made the correct fold, but mission just sticks it in you and shows you what you would have had. One for value on the top left. Again, value. Set call on the river. I don't know, maybe a little bigger bet would be better on the turn. I don't want to induce a raise. Now we're check calling. 3-4 missed. We're beating all the 5Xs. All the heart draws missed. So he's either going to have the nuts or nothing. Yep. Thank you, sir. And with a 7-3 here. Strand. Top left. I think this is a good float situation. We pick up equity. Rep a lot on turn cards. Have to. I don't think we have to bet big here. I think he's just going to give up a lot with like 8 dies, 10x. I don't think we're getting off a coin. But I think we can credibly barrel that. Yeah, we're just going to set up a good flop situation for ourselves. 4-way pot. Here comes the ace! Here it comes! So what do we do here? I don't think we can check. I think we just have to ship. Hope somebody has something. Not 3-4. I mean, somebody's going to have something to call with here, right? We can't give a free card. We're just going to get it in. And just hope we did not get sucked out on. That's not good. But this doesn't really mean anything. He could have eights or something. Or he could have pockets, freaking sixes, three. Oh, such a good spot. Such a good spot. That's supposed to be a triple up there. Yeah, that's our third buy-in we've dumped on that table. Such a good spot. It's so hard to hit a set. How do they do it? We had a 0.5 SPR on that flop. So hard for anybody to have anything. I mean, I think he does that with like 6x, pocket 7s, flush draws, huge amount of hands. He does the same exact thing there. Just has a set. Just has a strong. They're dead. Sick. Somebody do a little run good dance for me. Not gonna leave this table. Flush draw. All right. Well, since we have 8 high, I guess we just have to bet. And this player's pretty aggro, so maybe we just have to get it in. I don't know. Oh, well. That's pretty passive. Can we fold a flush draw against Getting 3-1, we're getting the right price. I think we just have to call here and keep this player in the pot and hope we can hit heart. Well, we're not hoping. We have the right price, right? Now we can just comfortably fold the turn. We had the right price. We didn't improve. I know we're getting paid if we hit our heart here, so slight odds. Now he's giving us 5-1. We need 4-1 to call. I mean, we have the right direct price, so we have to call, right? Okay. Now we're done. Take it to showdown. Could he have, like, a busted flush draw here, or 8-9? Could we be good here? We're obviously not getting anything to fold that has a pair, so we're back. Why would he raise queen 5 there? Well, we saved a dollar by not getting it in on the flop, right? That's so terrible. But we had the right price the whole way. We can't fault our play. We're just going to open 30 here with ace-jack. Maybe we can lose $12 on this. Like a primo table. We're just dropping buy-ins. This is we could be good here. I mean, this guy could just be trying to get it in with us because he thinks we're desperate. So this could be like ace-5 here. We're not really concerned about his 3-bet. Okay, we'll take a flip. We can win a flip king, please. Not win a flip. We will reload. Now down 4 buy-ins on this table. We get led into here. I think we can raise with our bottom pair. And get our free card on the turn. There's a lot of rivers we can just call leads. That's a really good card because he's probably not going to lead with an 8. A 7. So I think we just have the best hand here a lot. Wow, he was going to check raise, I guess. He doesn't have to have an 8 there. We can be good. Who's ready to get this freaking session over with? Freaking brutal, man. Got to be down like 30 bucks, right? 40 bucks even? We're down 12 on this one table. We're down 4 here, so that's 16. And we're down like 16 bucks on our tables that are open. And I don't think we were running good before we pulled these tables up, so I could see us being down like 30, 40 bucks this. But luckily, it's about to be over. Well, since we're in the big blind here, I guess we'll play one more revolution here, and we'll call the session. We may run over a little bit, but that's okay. So we got within a dollar of 25 and L again today. We just needed to break even basically past that point. But we've lost every flip. 100% sure we lost every flip. Ran into a set. We ran into a set with a top pair. Set with an over pair. And none of our draws got there in small pots. Right? Just basically run bad all the way around this session. Nothing, pretty much nothing went right, except for the first hand we won, right? An all-in. Keep going. Of course, if we were playing a full stack of 10 and L, you know, losing 5 buy-ins, 50 bucks in a session would not be unusual. If we're just losing less than that, doing okay. This is definitely becoming interesting, right? Under the gun raise. I guess we have to kill 20-1 implied odds. Tight. Guy only up a dollar. Me down 12. Getting all my money spread around equally. I guess so. I guess whoever took our money already left. Wow. Upset. Well, we're committed. We have SPR4 with top set. So I don't really care what turn card comes here. We're going to try and get some money in the pot. Oh, we're raising. A min raise is good. He's not going to fold any over pairs. Maybe even get him to come along with like ace highs here. But they definitely have to raise though on this board. Turn. Hopefully he has ace queen and we got him crushed. Yep, that's even better. Queen jack. Gave him the chance to call with two overs. Unfortunately, it's not a full double up, but hell, at this point, we'll take anything we can get, right? Anything we can get. This guy's only got 20 big blinds. I think we'll just chip. This guy wakes up with an overpaired ours. Good game, sir. All right. Get in versus king 5. Here's our 9. I think he's drawing dead. Yep. Okay, so we got... We went a $6 pot there. Finishing strong. Sitting out next big blind on all these. So we down to like dollar something there. So we got a little $4 in change. Leave my gut shot. We haven't hit any of these. You know. We've been leading so many gut shots. Not hit one single one. Can we hit a 4 of diamonds here? Or just win the pot, that works. That's even, that's not better, but I'll take a win. Take anything we can get right now, right? It's good that this variance has happened. I mean, it's going to happen. Let it happen at 10 and L, and at least you guys are seeing it happen firsthand. It can happen to anybody. Not that I'm some special person that it shouldn't happen to. I'm just saying it can happen. It can come out of nowhere and bite you right in the ass. But maybe it's just, maybe my win rate's just normalizing now. You know, I was running like 22 big blinds per 100. Obviously, that's not sustainable. I'm actually going to lose $1 here. So, I mean, right? It's got to normalize at some time. So all this, we get all through this, and I'm at 8 big blinds. It'll probably just my win rate, you know. I'll ISO this. Try to get this guy out of the pot. Well, I don't know if I want him out of the pot. I don't mind a 3-way pot with ace. And we get a good flop. We have an SPR of 3, less than 3. Like a beautiful spot for us. Just commit. Bet our 90 cents here and get it on any pretty much. We just ship here. We just ship. It's actually better. There's some 10x hands. He only has 20. It's a dangerous spot because there are better flush draws out there, but I still think with this price we have to call one. So we're done. Tables. Dead them. Two overs and better. I think we just call. We're basically in call down mode. He's giving price. Not the best run out. Whatever. Could he be doing this with like, he wouldn't be doing this with a 3, right? I think he's just giving us the right price here. Wow, I kind of want to call this. Could he be doing this with 7 out there? He wouldn't be doing it with that. Fold here. Screw it. I'm just going to fold. I mean, I think it's a bluff a lot. But, I mean, 68-27, he could be overvaluing, like, a 8 or a 10 of hearts or something there. You know? I don't want to value town myself. I think it's fine. It's just a bad run out. There's going to be so many better run outs for me there. I think probably 70% of run outs we can get to the river on. Call it off. I certainly could raise that flop and just get too, right? Raise the fours and probably be done with this session. We have a 50. Well, of course it's only hands, but definitely want to play pots with us there. Setting up a profitable spot for ourselves. Just got a lot better. Can we get this last 350 in on our last hand? Can we? Of course, it's going to be hard to get it in versus this player, but maybe this player could. I could certainly see a lot of aces in this range. Or at least King X to give us a couple streets of value here. So we have an SBR, a pretty good SBR here. We don't have to raise. I think he's never going to fold any turns with anyway. Flush draws. This is a good spot for us. Obviously, we have a set. this would be really sweet if we could get three-way all in here. And this guy's never folding now, so let's just get the money. This be our last hand of the session. Wow. The only way this guy could win is to hit a queen or a pair or something like that. So we want a nice little $9 pot there on our last pot, guys. That makes up for a lot, right? Definitely take that $6 boost to our bankroll on the last hand. So we want a $6 pot here and a $9 pot in our last two of our last three or four hands. So that definitely did not hurt. Definitely did not hurt. 143.50. We're up for the session. $1.50 now. That is insane. How is that possible? You mean we were only down like 10 bucks going to those last couple all-ins? Wow. You guys been following this all along? Is this real? Did I find some money somewhere? 143.50. We were at 141, I think, to start. Wow. We're up. What can I say? We're up for the session. That's like so weird to me that we could be up this session. But yeah, we're basically last four sessions we've been on a treadmill. But think about it. I mean, could you run any worse for at least the last three sessions? We're somehow finding a way to break even in our bad run, our run bad. I'm interested to see what my EV line. I actually have it downloaded in my hands. Wow. I had to move it off screen because I always forget if there's personal information on my. I don't want it to pull up my personal information on accident because then I'd have to end the stream right now. We have some hands to download. Obviously, not yesterday's yet, but I think I forgot to download yesterday. Quite a bit of hands. That may take too long. Let's look at it tomorrow, probably, right? Okay. That was a lot of fun. I hate to say it was a lot of fun. At least the ending was. There was a little bit of no fun there in the middle. But I am actually, once again, pleasantly surprised. It's much better to get pleasantly surprised. Like, feel like you're crushing it the whole session. Down like buy-ins. That's happened before. That's no fun. And I review sessions and I find out you forgot you lost those three or four all-ins right at the beginning of the session. Yeah, no punching bag session. So what do we say for this session?
Hey, everybody, we're all going to get laid.
I don't think it's that good of an ending, but that's, yeah, take it. What's going to happen next time, right? I need more positive sound effects, don't I? Maybe that's my problem, is I have way too many negative sound effects. Positive. Yeah, I know, right? I think I would have been down. Somehow. Actually, up. I'm glad I played that last revolution, right? Because I almost just sat out and quit, but we decided to play that one more revolution around, and we profited like 10 or 11 bucks because of it. Yeah. I do want to kind of continue. I got paperwork to do. I always tell my wife that I try to be done at 5, so somebody's going to be banging on my door soon. So I better call it. Yeah, I'm gonna quit. So, yeah. I'm happy. Thanks everybody for watching again. We will move on tomorrow. I'll definitely play. It's gonna be free money Friday for everybody. And we are gonna hit 150 tomorrow. We are gonna do it. Yeah. It is kind of tempting to play one heads up, sit, and go. Oh, I do that. There's somebody sitting. Okay, if there's somebody sitting waiting on a heads up, sit, and go, we'll sit. But if there's not, we're not going to sit. So let's find it here. Nobody's sitting. Not going to do it. Sorry, guys. So thanks again for watching. I'm going to go ahead and end this stream, and we will be back from Free Money Friday tomorrow. Maybe potentially get a little early start, maybe do a 2.5 hour session. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. Maybe even a 3 hour session. Who knows? I start at 2. Definitely want to get up to 25 and L. It's so gross to be stuck at 10 and L, but you know, the way I ran, I wouldn't. It's just amazing because if you think about it, we could easily be at like 80 bucks again. So the fact that we're still within striking distance of a couple buy-ins, I'm just really thrilled, honestly. So, but everybody, thanks again for watching this. We will talk to you tomorrow.